I'd like to invite Bonnie to give our affirming minute this morning. Thanks.
Good morning. On behalf of the Affirming Action Group, I want to invite you to what we consider a special film that's being shown at Grace Westminster this coming Wednesday evening. Could I have the first? This is a view from what's known as Stony Knoll. We look out now on a pastoral view of farmland, houses, barns, and other signs of agricultural settlement in this area that is near Laird, Saskatchewan. But I want you to reflect back upon the time of the signing of Treaty 6, which was signed in 1876. This land, of course, was still prairie, but not even 10 years after the signing of that treaty, the heart of the prairie would be gone. The bison would no longer be there. This land was designated as a reserve for the Young Chipewyan Band at the time of the signing of Treaty 6. But in the face of starvation, the people drifted away, leaving only the graves of their ancestors to mark their place. In 1897, the federal government unilaterally took away the land, but the memory of the people of the band was not lost. And they became one of Saskatchewan's, well, several of Saskatchewan's First Nations, whose chiefs were actual signatories to the treaties, but they currently have no land. Old stories and concerns were awakened when some of the original descendants of the Young Chipewyan Band came to town in the 1970s, insisting that a treaty was signed and the land now occupied by a group of local farmers was the former reserve. Needless to say, this didn't go down all that well. Over time, a group of Mennonites and Lutherans in the Laird area came to realize and acknowledge the history of this land where they now live. And this has been a long emotional journey. How many difficult truths and problems should be talked about with the sharing of food? A chief and descendants of the Young Chipewyan Band decided to invite the local community to a meeting at the central site of the former reserve. But the word meeting, I think, is a small word compared to what actually began from this coming together, officially a memorandum of understanding among the parties directly involved. This was long before the rest of us were actively discussing reconciliation. And the story that unfolds is a remarkable one, and the essence of this historical conundrum, the feelings, the questions, the detailed research, much of which was done by the Mennonite Church, the process of how people can address historical wrongs, this is captured in this engaging film. I happened to see this film at the public library this last year. It was made in 2016 and was produced through a collaboration of the Mennonite Central Committee Saskatchewan, St. John's Lutheran Church, Rebel Sky Media, with the support, of course, of the Mennonite Church of Canada. Just this summer, this film went with some of the people involved in the process to Ottawa to be viewed by a group of senators. One of the hardest obstacles remains the federal government. You may recall that in the early 1990s, Saskatchewan was involved with the land claim settlement process, which this assisted existing reserves to purchase more land. In 1994, the government of Canada admitted to inappropriately reclaiming Reserve 107. However, the land claim was denied because the government considered the Young Chipewyan Nation to be dissolved. They're being asked by this group to reconsider. And now you're being invited to view this 32-minute documentary and participate in a discussion that will follow, which is being led by Bill Robertson, who's a well-known educator, poet, and journalist. Grace Westminster is throwing open its doors Wednesday evening at 7 and inviting everyone to take a heritage tour of the church And then the film will begin at 7:30. I hope to see many of you there. Thank you.
Thank you, Bonnie.